The Adventure of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain, Longman Simplified English Series, read by Koshakon Sihanam. Chapter 9, Medicine. A new antimatter occupied Tom's mind. Becky Thatcher has stopped coming to school. Tom has struck with his pride for a few days and tried to forget her, but failed. He heard that he was ill. If she sounds dry, he no longer took an interest in swimming or even in Sherwood Forest. He went about very desperate. His aunt was worried and began to try all sorts of medicines known to him. She bought order health perhaps regularly and bereaved all the sorrow nonsense which they contained. The water treatment was new now, and Tom's raw condition was an unexpected piece of good fortune to her. She took him out and dried every morning, stood him up in the washer, and drowned him with a flask of cool water. Then she rubbed him down with a towel right since purple and so made him recover. Then she rolled him up in the red sheets and put him away under blanket. She swayed his soul green and the window strand of it came through the skin. As Tom says, yes, in spite of all this, the boy remained as says at the funeral. Aunt Polly decided that this depression must be broken up at any cost. Now she heard of pain cure. For the first time, she ordered a dozen bottles and swans. She tasted it and was filled with gratitude. It was simply fire in the liquid form. She gave Tom a teaspoonful and washed with the leaflet, excited for the resource. A wide look came into Tom's eye. He gave a deep breath and then stayed to rest around the room. Aunt Polly was delighted. Her troubles were over, for the depression was broken up. Tom felt that it was time to wake up and protect himself, so he thought over various plans of relief and finally decided to pretend to be friends of Prince Clever. He asked for it so often that he became a nuisance. His aunt ached, telling him to help himself and stop worrying her. But she wasn't the bottle. She regretted. She found that the medicine did really disappear, but it did not occur to her that the boy was carrying a crack in the sitting room floor with it. One day, Tom was giving medical attention to the crack when his aunt's yellow cat breeder came along, sitting eyeing the spoon greedily and begging for a taste. "Don't ask for it, Ari. You want it, Peter," says Tom. But Peter showed that he did want it. "Are you sure?" Peter was sure. "Now you ask for it, and I will give it to you because I'm not selfish. But if you find you don't take it, you mustn't blame anybody but yourself." Peter still seemed eager, so Tom forced his mouth open and pointed down. The pain skewered. Peter sprang a couple of yards into the air, sounds of war cries, and then fell round and round the room, banging against the furniture, upsetting the flower pot, and causing general destruction. Ned was on his back, raked and ran merrily around, screaming with joy. Then he went rushing round the house again, spreading more destruction in his path. Aunt Polly entered in time to see him take some unsettling leap into the air, give a final piercing scream, and sail to the open window, carrying the rest of the flower pot with him. The only Rarely stood tall to the floor with astonishment. Peering over her glasses, Tom lay on the floor, splitting his fist with rubber. Tom was no earth is wrong in the cat. I don't know, asked grieved the boy. Well, I have never seen anything right. What did make him behave like that? Indeed, I don't know, Aunt Polly. Cats only do that when they are enjoying themselves. They do they? There was something in her tone that made Tom expectable. The old lady bent down. The handle of Ted's spoon was visible under the rug. She took it and held it up. Tom looked scary. She raised him by the usual handle, his ear, and slapped him. Now, where did you get that poor, dumb creature right there? I was pretending to be this aunt. What do you mean? I was pretending to be his aunt and trying to burn the bone out of him. This was putting the matter in a new light. Was cruel to a cat's mind. Be cruel to a boy too. Began to soften. She felt sorry. Her eyes watered a little, and she put her hand on Tom's head and said gently, "I didn't mean to be cruel, Tom." And Tom, the medicine did to you good. I did him good too. The way he flew round and the room. Oh, run away before you make me lose my temper again. Try to be a good boy for once, and then you needn't take many more medicines. Tom Brace screwed every. It was noticed that this strutting has been occurring every day. Recently, he was beside Grace instead of playing with his friends. When Jeff Treasure appeared, Tom spoke to him and tried in a roundabout way to get some information about Becky, but the stupid boy could not understand. But what Tom wanted. Tom was and was hoping when a dish came in sight and hating the wonder of it as soon as he saw that she was not the wise one. Then one more dish played in at the gate and Tom's heart gave a great leap. The next instant he was shouting, rubbing, seizing boys, straining on his heart, jumping over the fence and the risk of lie and rape. Doing all the heroic, this hit clothing off and gifting an eye on Becky Thatcher. She to see if she was nodding. She never looked.
He broke to a group of boys, scattering them in every direction and fell beside Becky, almost upsetting her. She turns away with her nose in the air. Some people think they are very smart, he heard her say mockery. Tom's cheek burned. He rose to his feet and walked away, crushed.